One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Five. Six.
All right, thank you guys, thank you.
Adolescence. For many, this simple word represents immaturity, ignorance, a lack of knowledge about the world around us. However, in the words of a young girl named Anne Frank, the forming of a person's true character lies within their own hands. The writings of Anne Frank challenge traditional ideas of a teenage girl's mind. During Nazi-occupied Germany in the 1940s, Germany, Holland, Amsterdam, all of those areas, she wrote about positivity in a way that hadn't been explored by people of her age during that time. Throughout her hiding, with multiple different families in a very crammed space, a lot of tension both outside, inside, and inside the home, all of her ideas of positivity were kept within herself and were put in a private journal that wasn't discovered until quite a while after she had passed away, and it was discovered by her father. And what her father found was that through these writings, he saw a different side of his daughter that he had never seen before. You see, when she was in hiding with him, and he looked at her as his daughter as a child, he didn't see the truth behind her thoughts and her ideas and her perception of the things around them. He saw in her a sense of ignorance about the war, an immature look at how she should treat her mother and other people with authority and that are older, how she should treat her elders. But looking back on her writing years after she died, he saw that she really did understand in a way that he wasn't able to see during that time. The writings of Anne Frank challenge the ideas set forth through adolescence, such as being unaware of the severity of situations of a war, having the need, let's say, to explain things in the most realistic way rather than with what feels the best for you. For instance, the adults in the house, they might say, there's a war going on, we don't have enough food, you should be hungry, you should be upset. And Anne would take that and she would put in her journal, I don't see why we should be upset. Because being negative about the situation isn't gonna help anyone. And can you imagine if all of us put our negativities on each other, how awful it would be to be where we are. For young girls that get to read this book right here, have a copy of it, by Anne Frank, it's her diary. It's actually an edited version by her father to take out a couple things that were a bit questionable about her mother that he didn't approve of. But here in the diary, when young girls read it, whether it's in middle school, high school, whatever age, it really opens up the idea that young girls are not imprisoned by adolescence, and really their ideas can have significant weight. Their words can have meaning. And they can be taken and morphed into positive ideas that can change the world. Before, as a child, everyone looks at you and they say, you know, your words that you say, they don't mean as much as the adults. They don't have as much weight because I've been here longer, I know more, I see the situation. But this book disproves that. It really shows that even with a lack of knowledge on certain maybe war aspects, whatever it may be, you can still have an idea of how to change the world and how to bring positivity. A quote from Anne Frank is, how wonderful it is that you needn't wait 1 minute to change the world. And she really is right in that. In every time that she picked up a pencil to write something down in her journal in 1944, 1943, whatever year that it was that she was in hiding, she wrote down a message that would later be spoken and heard, even if she thought that it would never be heard. It did, and those ideas altered the viewpoints of people that were within the war. The people affected often, I believe, would look at things in a very negative way, with fear and tension and anger towards whatever side it may be. But I feel like for Anne, the heroism of her true beliefs is to find the peace within herself and to want to put that onto others and put that in her writing. For Anne Frank, I believe that the word adolescence does not represent immaturity, a lack of knowledge, or anything of that nature, but rather represents courage and strength and an insatiable pursuit of love and peace for all, even in a time that's filled with tension and anger that she may have been told that she didn't understand.